Many Magic the Gathering players ask the question, is it worth it to buy 5 basic lands for $29.99? Wait a minute. 5 basic lands for $29.99. Oh no, that means...
No secret layer alert! No secret layer alert! No secret layer alert! No secret layer alert!
It's just so many secret layers! This time, it's Secret Lair Godzilla Lands. That's the real name of this product, by the way. Secret Lair Godzilla Lands. So that's where we are now. 5 basic lands, each full art and foil, and illustrated with Godzilla. There's also a code to get sleeves, but not the lands, on MTG Arena. Price is $29.99. So is it worth it to buy these 5 basic lands for $29.99? Well, the answer may surprise you. In my evaluation, there's really no problem with this product whatsoever in terms of price and contents. Now hang on, I got other problems, and I'll talk about them in a moment. But honestly, selling premium art versions of basic lands is actually the perfect encapsulation of everything Secret Lair should be. Everyone, and I mean everyone, has access to basic lands for, well, I'd like to say free, but then some people in the comments will be pedantic and argue the claim that they're not really free, but let's just say the value of a basic land is a couple of pennies. By offering a premium version of a card available at or below a couple of pennies, Wizards of the Coast has created a product you literally, literally only need to buy if you want it. You do not in any way, however small, need to purchase this to play any version of the game. It is purely a product for aesthetic purposes. It is a skin. To ask, is it worth it to buy Secret Lair Godzilla Lands, is akin to my asking, is it worth it to buy an Animal Crossing skin bundle for your Nintendo Switch? The answer to both is simple and fair. Do you want this? Do you like the art and enjoy the aesthetic? And do you have the disposable cash to afford it as a pleasure purchase for yourself? If so, then purchase it for yourself and enjoy. They're basic lands. This is a skin. If you do not like the artwork, then don't buy it. Now, I personally am not a Godzilla fan, so I don't really want these. But if this had been full art Lorwyn or Ravnica lands instead of Godzilla, then yeah, I probably would have picked up a copy. Now, I do think it's worth noting that although it doesn't reflect on this product in isolation, I do want to add that it is very upsetting that previous Secret Lair drops have still not successfully arrived to a notable amount of customers. Quite frankly, that does not speak well to the overall quality and assurance of the product line. Neither does the fact that the foiling of these are such poor quality that they will likely arrive significantly curled and questionably playable before you even take them out of the package. But to be fair, that is what foils are and do nowadays. So, I don't know, I guess that's another video. Another legitimate concern I do have for this product is the fact that, once again, it is something we once received as part of booster packs being removed from them and separately monetized. Just like masterpieces have been, just like a lot of things have been, special full art lands have been included not just in Zendikar booster packs, but there were full arts in Amonkhet as well. So many Tolarian Community College professors cannot help but ask the question, why aren't these full art Godzilla lands just in Ikoria booster packs, perhaps in a fashion similar to the Amonkhet full lands? Why do they have to be removed and sold separately? Hello? Oh yeah, it's money. Well, if we are now examining financial worth of this product, despite my frustrations about these not being in booster packs, it is fair to say there is highly likely to be value here. Let's compare to the most similar Secret Lair drop, Secret Lair Eldraine Wonderland, which contained, that's right, 5 basic lands in foil, except that for Eldraine Wonderland, they were snow-covered basics. Also, originally sold for $29.99, we can look at the prices now about 5 months later and see that if I wanted to buy one of each of the Eldraine snow-covered lands, well, holy wow, the island is going for $20 to $30 each already. The forest is pretty stable at 12 bucks a pop, the mountain only $8, plains are at $8.85, and bottom of the list is swamp at $8 each. But again, I don't really care about the prices of these premium snow-covered lands, not the price that Wizards was charging for them, nor the price that they're selling for now in the secondary market. Why? Because non-premium versions exist due to reprints. Snow-covered lands were reprinted meaningfully in Modern Horizons. There was one in every pack. And thus, if I need a snow-covered island, I need not spend $30 each. I need only spend 77 cents and erect a firm mana base using the Modern Horizons art. See, reprints like these can be a rousing success. And so ultimately, who really cares that either of these secret layers cost $29.99 when they each have versions of the cards available for mere pennies. If only Secret Lair Ultimate Edition had been released after or even concurrent with meaningful reprints of the Fetchlands, I think that people might not have gotten so upset at its intended price of a bit more than $165. Let's just say for the video that they were supposed to be $199.99. And I think the fervor might have been less if only affordable versions had been reprinted for us. Then you could have done that secret layer at $199.99 and... wait a minute, something is not right here. To the math board! All right, Secret Lair Eldraine Wonderland, 5 lands, foil, not full art, $29.99. Secret Lair Godzilla Lands, 5 lands, foil, full art, $29.99. Secret Lair Ultimate Edition, 5 lands, non-foil, not full art, intended price of $199.99. This doesn't add up. Even if we take Wizards of the Coast at their word that a product like Signature Spellbook Chandra has a completely different cost to produce and distribute than Secret Lair Ultimate Edition, here we have 3 almost identical products, all under the same product name. And they're all 5 lands. Yeah, some have foil and some not. Some full art and some not. But 5 lands in the same product line, Secret Lair, and we see the prices being $29.99. Okay. $29.99, okay. And then that intended price of $199.99. Now, never minding the disastrous and easily foreseeable result of the Secret Lair Fetchlands Edition going for not $200, but rather $400 each, even at that intended price of about $200, this is revelatory to us about many things. It reveals Wizards of the Coast not only pays full attention to the secondary market, but is also designing new products to specifically profit from it, a behavior that is both morally and certainly legally questionable. It reveals, too, that card reprints are influenced by the secondary market and demand, but not in the way they should be. Wizards of the Coast has positioned itself as desiring cards to be expensive so as to profit from their own manufactured demand. Lastly, given the role that Fetchlands play as a must-have card for serious participation in formats such as Modern and Legacy, it reveals that Wizards of the Coast is intentionally working to limit access and interest in these formats. They want to keep them expensive. In other words, because they are now monetizing that expense. And before this turns into another Talarian Wins, I want to bring these points back to Secret Lairs. I've had extremely conflicted thoughts and feelings towards Secret Lairs since the product line was first announced, and those feelings have become more frustrated and conflicting as more Secret Lair drops have been revealed. I mean, you know me, and I am, if nothing else, always striving to be fair. And when several previous Secret Lairs offered a good value to the customer, despite the implications to local game stores, I spoke positively of those Secret Lair drops in isolation of their greater ramifications and graded accordingly, and then offered my thoughts on those greater ramifications in a follow-up commentary video. But as we see more and more of these Secret Lairs, as my feeling of dis-ease with them, even when it is a goodbye, grows more and more, we start to see the truth about the product revealed. The truth being that Secret Layers are not reprints, but rather they are a method for Wizards of the Coast to monetize aspects of Magic the Gathering that were normally closed to them. In the past, if a card reached a high price on the secondary market, Wizards of the Coast couldn't really profit off of that. Their only means of making money off of expensive cards was to reprint them in booster packs, and then sell those booster packs for $4 each, then $6 each, then $10 each, then $14 each, then $24 each. But with Secret Layers, Wizards of the Coast can target any card on the secondary market and print it for their own profit. Only again, I must stress, this is them reprinting it at the secondary market price. Or more accurately, at about 20% below. Those 20% numbers that I put forward in my previous video match up not only to Secret Layer fetch lands, but the other Secret Layer reprints we have seen in $29.99 Secret Layer drops, and even the $49.99 Secret Layer drops. Everyone seemed so shocked that the fetch lands were not in a $29.99 Secret Layer, but I had said as early as my very first video on Secret Layers that there is no way Wizards of the Coast would ever reprint all five fetch lands in a $29.99 or even $49.99 Secret Layer, or even one of them. They aren't looking to reprint these cards. They are looking to profit off the secondary market with them. What about Secret Layer Godzilla Lands? This is them monetizing not needed reprints, but another highly lucrative aspect of the secondary market that Wizards of the Coast has long been unable to tap into, card alters. We've seen this with the new push towards selling the Godzilla alternate art cards in their $25 to $30 Ikoria collector boosters. These are essentially official card alters. We can even see this with the cartoony and non-typical MTG style artwork of the previous Secret Layer drops. This is Wizards of the Coast looking at how much money players are willing to pay to have their enlightened tutor altered to look like Baby Yoda or whatever, and saying, hey, how can we get in on that? And the result clearly is what we are seeing today. And yet, what are we, the consumer, to do? When Wizards of the Coast comes along offering you a special art edition of a card you want for 20% less than market price, knowing it will sell out whether you buy it or not, the equation shifts heavily towards you simply taking advantage of the opportunity given. But nonetheless, I do believe strongly that Secret Layer Ultimate Edition is a product that has gone too far, attempted to profit too much and unfairly, and that we should never cease in our demands for meaningful reprints of cards such as Fetchlands. But in terms of five basic lands with special art for $29.99, well, final conclusion? Secret Layer Godzilla Lands is worth it if you like the artwork on the lands, and only if you like the artwork on the lands. You do not need to buy this product for any other reason. There is literally a library worth of special artwork basic lands for you to choose from and match to your personal aesthetic. You do not need to buy this product. However, if you do love Godzilla and you do like the artwork here, then it is highly likely these lands will retain, if not increase, in value. And since this is not a must-have product, and since these are cards with affordable versions available to everyone, literally everyone, then yeah, the grade here is an A-. The minus, as mentioned, a result of the issues established through previous Secret Layer foiling and delivery assurance issues. No, I don't want the Animal Crossing skin for my Switch. I want the Pokemon skin with the Johto starters. I gotta go. I hope very much this video has been of some help to you. You can help me out by remembering to like, subscribe, leave a comment, and especially by passing along a copy to a friend. Let me know in the comments below if you plan to pick up Secret Layer Godzilla Lands and what you think the ultimate direction of Secret Layers is. completely honest with you here. One of my deep fears as a lover of the local game store is that this pandemic might just be a point where in a lot of the meetings, the answer is, well, let's just put all of our attention, all of our effort post-pandemic into digital. Like this is digital all in or nothing. You're saying that the local game stores are still a big, important part of this equation and a part of recovery efforts?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, let me say this. I know there's this fear out there that somehow we're just going to make Magic a digital game and just get rid of tabletop. I think there's this fear that we're going to phase out tabletop over time or something.
Yes, huge fear.
And what so number one, tabletop is an organic main way of Magic. It currently right now, I mean, not during the pandemic, but normally we make more money off tabletop Magic than anything else.